to you. What you write is what we do. The words are all by you. Up to you. Imagination is the clue. You know it's up to you. You to us. Us to you. Your ideas coming through. Dreams and hopes from on the lopes. Some are funny, some are blue. The words are from your heart and hands, so we sing. Here's to you.
Letters, stories, words by you. Letters, stories, words by you.
Here's to you.
Would you like to see us make? Everybody put your hand down. What kind of animal would you like?
How about a cockroach?
We'd love to make you a cockroach. In fact, we'll make you three cockroaches. The soda machine.
Every day, in goes the money.
Cling, plop.
Out comes the soda.
Swish, swash. Don't forget the ice. Crunch, crunch.
It's so annoying to hear the slurp, slurp, slurp of the empty cups every single day.
You actually think it's fun being a soda machine?
Well, it's not.
Cling,
plop.
Swish, swash.
Crunch, crunch.
Listening to those noises can drive you up a wall, considering you are against one.
Clang.
Crunch.
It's hard to forget the kicking and hitting.
When I don't give you your cup.
Cling.
Crunch. Crunch.
Someone's coming. I've got to go now. Bye.
Cling.
Plop.
Crunch, crunch.
Once, he invented the solar-powered electric blanket. But it didn't work, because you could only use it in the daytime. He invented inflatable basketballs, like balloons. But they didn't work, because every time you used them, they popped.
Pop.
He tried to invent eatable records, but they didn't work because, every time you put them on the turntable, they got dirty. Tasted terrible anyway. He invented the movie camera. It had already been invented.
Wow.
And nothing he ever did worked.
Oh, wow.
That's okay. I love him anyway.
Thank you. try not to fright, but in the light of it all, if you're ever down, remember the left field wall. Remember the left field wall.
Things weren't looking too good.
We're at the plate. Harold stood.
From the stands there came a boo! Hey, Harold, what you trying to do?
In that fateful game, each team had tried.
But try they might, the score was tied.
Strike one!
Boo!
But now the game was in Harold's hands. No matter the reaction from the stands.
Strike two!
Harold wasn't too good, you see. Many times before, he'd heard, "You're out! Strike three."
After his hit, he'd shocked them all. For with a mighty swing, he cleared the left field wall!
Yay! The fans, they roared!
And Harold's heart soared.
The fans and players left the park!
But Harold stayed, happy as a lark.
Now, I don't know if he's still there, but I've got something that I'd like to share. Some people say old Harold's ghost lurks near, but personally, I think it's not something to fear.
So if you hear a bump in the night, try not to fright, but in the light of it all, if you're ever down, remember the left field wall.
Oh, remember the left field wall.
So if you hear a bump in the night, try not to fright, but in the light of it all, if you're ever down, remember the left field wall. Oh, remember the left field wall.
In Paris, France, there is a cathedral called Notre Dame. It is a huge building covered with gargoyles.
A gargoyle is a building decoration carved to look like a horrible human or animal figure.
The Cathedral of Notre Dame has three of these weird things sitting on a wall in front of the huge building.
And way above the three gargoyles, on top of the church, are three large bell towers.
Every Sunday, someone who worked for the cathedral rang the giant bells in all three bell towers. Every Sunday, the people of the town expected to hear the melodies that came from the bells.
Very late, one hot summer night, something very unusual happened.
It was very dark, and everyone was asleep.
Just like any other Wednesday night.
Except for one thing. At the cathedral, the gargoyles were stirring. First, one gargoyle came to life. Then the second.
Until all three gargoyles were talking to each other. The leader said, "Hey, I'm tired
of the bells getting all the attention. We're just as pretty to look at as they are to hear. Let's do something to show how we feel. After some whispering, the three gargoyles got off the wall. Cathedral, to the stairs,
and up
to the towers. One gargoyle went to each tower. Then their leader gave them the signal, and the gargoyles began pulling the ropes that rang the bells.
The noise woke everyone up. No one knew where the commotion was coming from. So they got dressed and ran to the cathedral. When they got there, everything was quiet.
The gargoyles watched proudly from the wall.
As the people of the town tried to see who was ringing the bells at that hour in the middle of the week.
Of course, the towers were empty. To this day, when they feel like it, the gargoyles pull the same trick on the people of the town. And no one has discovered the gargoyle's secret.
And now it's time for our short stories. Steve will do Sometimes When I'm Alone by Emily Stuckey, Ann Arbor, Michigan. Carlo will do Proud by Karen Ganley, age 12, Sparta, New Jersey. Wynn will perform The Lone Track Meet by Shannon Ledesma, age 12, Hoquiam, Washington. And John will do Perfection by Alexandra Jacobs, age 9, New York, New York.
Sometimes, when I'm alone, I think I'm going to grow up to be someone very important. My mom thinks so, too. But I can't imagine who. I love my mom. All the boys on my block say, ah-ha, ah-ha. But I know they love their moms, too.
I'm proud. Not an arrogant proud. Not a strong, proud feeling. Not a proud of just one thing. Just a happy feeling about myself, proud. Proud about what I can do. Proud about what I am doing. Proud about my abilities in everything.
Calls my name from the long jump pit. I can feel my heart run in a race of its own. Then, running down to the pit as fast as I can, my heart's beating, my arms pumping, my stomach's flying with butterflies, I hit the board. Thoughts go racing through my mind of the months of practice and preparation. As I fly through the air, wind in my face, I land solid as a rock. There's dirt in my shoes and everywhere. But I'm proud because I won the track meet with myself.
I never boast. I never lie. I know it all. I don't know why. I'm modest, and I'm very sweet. And I have the nicest feet. I spell like a wonder. I know arithmetic. 5 + 5 = 3, isn't it? I'm not superstitious, or so they predict. I don't love food. I'm just an addict. P.S. Though this poem may make you quite delirious, I'm not kidding. This poem is serious.
Kids' Rights will be back after these messages.
Down at Fraggle Rock.
Down at Fraggle Rock.
I love Fraggle Rock.
Chris, why don't you read something?
Do I have to?
Well, dinner's not ready for an hour.
But the Fraggles are really fun.
Center of the
now year. Reading can be as enjoyable as watching Fraggle Rock on TV with a new Fraggle Rock Club. Jim Henson's family of Muppets make reading fun for your 3 to 7 year old. Call now and get What's a Fraggle on approval for $3.99 plus delivery, a free book, and this Fraggle Rock record and tote bag. We'll send 2 books about every 6 weeks at $3.99 per book. You can cancel after 4 more shipments.
But Fraggles love to read.
He's finally found books he really likes.
Discovering the Fraggle Rock Club is a terrific idea.
With free gifts, it pays to join the Fraggle Rock Club. Call 1-800-342-3000.
You've known him as a hero.
Oh, Cadichon.
You've known him as a farmer's worst nightmare.
You lazy, good-for-nothing donkey.
You've even known him as a maniac with a thing for underwear and mud. But what you don't know is what he's up to now. Because Cadichon hasn't just been cooling out in his meadow like most donkeys. No! Lately, he's been busy getting in even more trouble. And this weekend, you get to share his latest adventure. It's Cadichon 2, this Saturday at 3, 2 Central. A special delivery from Nickelodeon.
You're watching Nickelodeon. And now, back to Kids' Rights.
It is so cold outside because of the snow. And as I look out the frosty window, it seems to be moving so slow.
Motionless snow.
But is it really moving? The cold glitter and shine makes the whole world look like it's frozen in time.
Motionless snow.
Does it really matter if the snow moves or not? Does anybody care about the snow that ties time in a knot? Yes, some people do. Some people that I even know. People that like to look out the window and glance at the motionless snow. Makes it look like the entire world is frozen in time.
Motionless snow. Motionless snow. Motionless snow.
Sometimes I feel like no one likes me. Sometimes I feel like I have a lot of friends. Sometimes I feel like my cat does not like me. Sometimes me and my sister get in fights. We make up. I wish that I could be like my sister.
My brother plays the guitar. He's the very best brother by far. He's very, very nice and worth a very high price. He likes to dress up in the finest pants, and he's kind to every animal, even ants. He can swim great, and when there's a party, he's never late. He likes to drive our houseboat and dress up in his suit and coat. I'm sure you'd like to meet him. And by the way, his sister's name is Kim.
It was Christmas time, and for John Philip, it was great because he always wanted a guitar, and this year he finally got one. As he was riding his bike, he saw a sign that said,
Guitar contest, guitar contest, guitar contest, woo, woo, guitar contest, guitar contest, guitar contest, woo, woo, come on in and sign your name, come on in and sign your name.
He went in and asked what the prize was.
She said 50,000.
He was so shocked, he went and practiced for a full 7 months. He heard the announcer and Philip John scream.
Hey, you won the 50,000. The announcer made a mistake.
It wasn't Philip John. It was you, John Philip.
John was so happy he split the money with Philip John.
3 years later, they met and made a group that was so good. Come on in and sign your name. Come on in and sign your name. Come on in and sign your name.
What you do, the words are all by you.
KidsWrites. KidsWrites.